hell are you? I asked you a question. You'd better answer pretty damn quick.
I thought you'd like a nightcap.
I don't have much cash, a few traveler's checks, one or two.
You heard what my brother said. A nightcap.
What's your game?
Take your coat off. Relax.
What's all this about?
Always questions.
You've been drinking.
That's considerate.
Very considerate.
And you look like you've been enjoying yourself.
We hope so.
Now take your coat off. Please. Sit down over there.
Now I play around. Hmm? Come out with it, eh? Just tell me what the hell it is you want.
We want you to drink this. It's very good brandy.
VSOP.
Take it.
It's not poison.
Over 20 years old.
Try it. Please. Oh, go ahead.
Genuine?
Okay, so now I've had a drink. Perhaps...
You're a pilot, aren't you, Niccolo?
Have you ever crashed in the sea?
So what's this that's so pressing?
Well, I don't know if it is pressing, really. But you know that lady you've spoken to a couple of times in here runs the boutique in the Gallstraße.
The beautiful Diane, yes, of course. What about her?
She's been asking questions.
How flattering.
She's worth something, that one.
She certainly is. So what about the questions?
She wanted to know if you really were commissaris at the Mannixstraße.
Naturally, you told her I'm chairman of Philips International.
She seemed a little disturbed, so I thought perhaps I'd better get in touch with you. Try that. Commissaris.
Amazing. I've never seen a drink like that before in my life. What a color. You think it's really going to do the trick?
County?
Yes. We usually have a bit more water in it, don't we? What do you think's really behind these questions?
I don't know. But I did say that if she wanted to see you, I could probably arrange it. Thought you might be interested, you know. Talk of the Diao. Mademoiselle.
Hello.
Hello, Diao.
How opportune.
Surprise, surprise.
I see Yap has been talking to you.
You didn't expect him to?
May I have one of those, please, yeah?
Certainly, my dear.
May I talk to you?
Of course, why not?
Let's sit over there.
Is that an order?
We need a little privacy.
Lead the way.
I'm terribly thirsty.
Oh, please. Well?
Do you undertake private commissions?
No.
Never?
Never.
Well, at least we have a basis for negotiation.
It's a starting point, certainly.
Well, I can see I've amused you.
Well, you know, it is ridiculous.
Well, at least listen to what I have to say. Last week, a friend of mine, Niccolò Ranieri, fell and was drowned. He'd been drinking heavily.
That's a close friend?
Close enough.
Yeah, well, I'm afraid I know nothing about it. You see, I've got a lot to think about.
Please, let me finish. A few months ago, another friend of mine, Harm Barker...
That's also close?
Also close. ...was killed in a car smash. At the autopsy, it was found he had consumed the better part of a bottle of brandy.
You've had some very alcoholic friends, but what else am I supposed to say?
I don't think their deaths were coincidental. I think it's possible that they were murdered.
Niccolò Ranieri. Body found approximately 7:15 in the morning of the 7th. Death by drowning. Contusions on the back of the head consistent with fall while getting in or out of bath.
Yeah.
Best part of a bottle of spirits. No evidence to suggest any outside involvement.
And Barker?
Alcohol again. Ran out of road driving his Mercedes. It's all in here.
Listen, there's a boutique in the Kalverstraat called Chic. It's owned by a French woman.
Diane Laclos.
Oh, you know her?
Met about a year ago. One of her assistants was robbing her. I remember thinking at the time. Is there any connection between her and them?
I don't know about that. Look, this is all unofficial at this stage, you understand?
All right, yeah, I understand.
You remember thinking what?
Some women. You meet him for the first time, and right away you know.
What?
That they're 1,000 miles of bad road.
And that incredibly vivid metaphor struck you when you met Diane Laclos?
Yes, it did.
I got you a pastis.
So I see.
Aren't you going to sit down?
Thank you. I see you were pretty confident I would turn up.
Oh, let's just say optimistic. I thought it was more discreet to meet outside Amsterdam.
Mm-hmm.
Did you check up?
Me? Check up?
On Niccolo and Harm.
Yes, of course I checked up. I wouldn't be here if I hadn't.
Did you think I'd made them up?
I couldn't be sure.
Why are you suspicious of me?
You ask me to undertake a private eye job, knowing perfectly well that I'm a commissaris, that you're a beautiful lady.
Oh, flattering.
It's not meant to be. All right. You say you've been threatened now.
Yes, I have. When I woke up this morning, I found this on my pillow. Someone must have got into the flat last night. You don't believe me.
I don't know.
Then I won't waste any more of your time.
Sit down, please.
This is a funeral card. Now, whose funeral can that mean but mine? Why? How? How can I make up something like that?
All right, I believe you. I said, all right, I believe you.
Well?
Here we go. Right, have you been looking over your shoulder recently?
What do you mean?
I mean that you should have been. I think someone has you under glass.
You think I'm being followed?
It's odds on.
Would you cancel order, sir?
Well, I don't think we've quite made up our minds yet, have we, darling?
Oh, no, no, we haven't, darling.
No hurry, sir. No hurry.
I'm your new boyfriend taking you out to dinner, okay? Mm-hmm. Now then, can I ask you a few questions? Just keep looking deliriously happy and give me honest answers.
All right.
Diane Laclos, French.
Parisienne.
What are you doing in Amsterdam?
I came here 3 years ago, fell in love with the place, and I've been here ever since.
Mm-hmm. Married?
No.
Never?
No.
Lived with someone?
The man that I loved was already married.
Uh-huh. But you were his mistress?
Yes, for 10 years.
Are you still?
No, he died. That's when I came to Amsterdam.
Enemies?
Enemies?
Yes, do you have any that you know of?
No, no. Not that I know of, darling.
Well, I think it's about time we ordered, yeah? Let's see. Ah, les paupières de veau aux olives.
Sounds perfect.
So, since your man died 3 years ago, you've had two lovers, Ranieri and Bacca. Right?
Yes.
Just two.
Je m'en fous.
Okay. And now they're dead. And you say it can't be an accident.
No. Someone must hate me very much.
Well, that's got to be the understatement of the year. The man you loved for 10 years, what did he do?
He was a businessman.
does that mean?
He owned a chain of butcher shops.
Oh, butcher? Well.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Oh, nothing. It's just I find it difficult to imagine you tied up with a man who chops up meat.
I do believe you're romantic.
Romantic, really? I'm a realist.
Well, that's difficult to imagine. Are we being followed?
No. Your butcher's wife.
What about her?
Well, did she know?
No, no.
So that possibly eliminates the jealous wife trying to get at you.
Yes. She died last year.
Boy, it really follows you around, doesn't it?
Two locks. And two bolts. Well, you're security conscious.
A woman living alone, most of the time, has to be, doesn't she?
Yes.
He certainly didn't come through that door.
Oh.
Et voila?
Yes.
Would you like a drink? I'm going to have a brandy.
Oh, yes, all right. What an unusual set. Do you play?
No, I don't play.
Oh, really?
No. I like to look at them, to pick them up, to feel them, the way you're doing now. It's satisfying, isn't it?
Oh, yes, it is.
You play, of course.
Why, of course?
Oh, I don't know, but... I'm right, aren't I?
Yes, I play all right. Very badly.
Oh, such humility. Would you like a cigar?
Partagas. Well, you really are spoiling me, aren't you?
Oh, not at all. I smoke them myself sometimes.
Really? Just as I'm trying to give them up. Do you mind if I have it later? Are you saying you had your bedroom window open all night?
Yes, but it's impossible to get through there.
Mm-hmm. And these, you locked these before you went to bed?
Well, I think so.
And he could have slipped this one. Yeah, I think this is how he came in. But what's it all about? Hmm? He was obviously making you more receptive, softening you up. What for?
I really don't know. What should I do?
I don't know. I'm thinking.
What's your wife like?
Oh, did I say I was married?
No.
She's rather lovely, I think, and a lot of fun.
How refreshing.
What's that?
That you still find her attractive.
Oh, yes, yes. I see you have one of my favorites.
Oh, that's not mine. Someone left it here.
Really? Don't disillusion me. May I?
Help yourself. Would you like a coffee with your brandy?
Yes, I think that would be a good idea. Black and strong with no sugar, eh?
10 minutes, all right?
Fine. I see you have another of my favorites, Stendhal. Or did someone leave that behind as well?
No, that's mine.
Good.
One day I'll get around to reading it. You said you were thinking. Have you come to any conclusion?
My hunch is that you're not in any danger. Yet.
You really think so?
Yes, I think their next move will be against someone else who's close to you, as you've put it.
There is no one else.
Come over here.
You've seen something?
Yes, don't look at her. Just smile at me. As if you're falling in love. Now you get close to me.
As if we were starting a relationship?
That's right.
Seven, three, nine, LG, 7-3. French registration.
To me. I had to let him go.
Clumsy.
No way, he's clever.
We go ahead as planned.
He's troubled.
If he gets in the way, then...
I say we take him out first.
Are you getting nervous, Sean?
He's troubled.
You said that.
All right, I said that. I repeated myself. And I'll repeat myself again. We take him out.
Well, it's good of you to drop by, Effan.
Well, it's on my way, isn't it? How let away, is she?
What makes you say that? Oh, no, it's not. Yes, actually, she's down at the cottage. I've got spotted leave coming up, and... So, do you fancy some of this?
Fine.
So she's giving it the annual spring clean, ready for the summer. I guess she's cutting loose with a paintbrush by now.
Thanks. I imagine she's pretty good in that direction.
She's better than I am, I'll tell you that. That's not saying much. Take a seat.
Thanks.
Now, I want you to do me one more favor, if that's all right with you.
Are we still extracurricular?
Yes, just. But it's about to go into the machine. Any objections?
No.
You look doubtful.
Well, I'm not.
What are you thinking about? Don't tell me 1,000 miles a bad road.
I'm sure you know what you're doing, Pete.
You are? Well, that's good, because I'm not.
Anyway, if you need help, official or otherwise, just let me know.
Thanks. First of all, French registration number here. I just want to know the owner of the car, okay? Now then, to get back to Diane Laclos.
Mm-hmm.
What do you mean, mm-hmm? There's nothing going on there, yeah. This is strictly business. There's nothing going on.
I am not saying there is, Pete.
Right. Now, this was taken 7 or 8 years ago. It's her companion I'm interested in. He seems strangely familiar.
He's strangely familiar, all right. That's Philippe Baptiste.
What is it? What do you want?
You do as you are told, and you talk to no one. You do, and it'll be unlucky for your new man. Unlucky for him, and then unlucky for you. Like Ranieri and Baca. You understand?
What do you want? What do you want me to do?
Tomorrow. Midday, you go to your bank and you take out the contents of your deposit box. And remember the card. The card and Ranieri. Baca.
She must have called him.
Maybe. Maybe not.
What's that supposed to mean?
Even if she did, it doesn't make much difference. In fact, it could be an advantage. We'll know where he is, won't we?
Who is it?
On the phone.
Honest answers, huh?
Honest answers?
That's right. That's what you said you'd give me. He's been dead for 3 years, you said. He's alive and well, and now he's out of prison. A butcher, you said. He owned a chain of butcher shops. Well, I suppose that is one way to describe a gangster who owns a chain of killers.
How did you find out?
Why'd you keep it? Sentiment?
Possibly.
I like that.
The rumor has it that you're the one who put him behind bars. Yes, that is a cause for sentiment, I suppose.
It's not that funny.
It's not.
You don't exactly have the background, do you?
Oh, of course, the background, yes. You've got to tell me all about your childhood and how it made Piaf look as if she'd been born with a silver spoon in her mouth. Well, of course, I admit that's true in a way. After all, Philippe did drag you out of the gutter, didn't he? Well, not so much the gutter as the whorehouse.
That's enough.
Fine. Now, what was the background?
Why don't you leave now?
What is the background?
I didn't put him behind bars.
So what did you do?
He stopped coming around.
He found another friend?
Yes, but that didn't matter. There had been others.
So?
So? He stopped coming around.
I don't think so. I think it did matter. You still loved him.
Yes, I loved him. But I decided to get out.
With profit.
Why not?
You went straight to Jean-Paul Laurent, and you told him all about the dope run.
You seem to know it all. Why ask me?
I just want it confirmed.
Yes, I went to Laurent. It was he who tipped off the police.
But not before he'd cashed in on the dope. And what was your cut of that, Diane?
Diamonds.
Nice. And now Philippe Baptiste is out. His sons are onto you. They've finally tracked you down. I have to hand it to you for your nerve, asking me to help you.
I really had no alternative. I knew I was taking a big risk when I went to Oran. But it wasn't just for myself. It was also for my son.
That's Baptiste's son?
Yes. But he didn't believe it was his. To tell the truth, he threw me out when I told him I was pregnant.
And you went to Oran for revenge?
No. To ensure the future for myself and my son.
And where is he now?
Hidden safely from Philippe.
I think you'd better answer that.
Hello? Yes. Yes. I see. I understand. Well, you really made a mistake coming back here.
That was then?
Yes.
I thought it was.
You can't leave now.
Oh, I can't.
No. If you do, they said they'd kill you.
You know, I think you really are telling the truth at last.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry.
Honest answers.
Honest answers. That was the second call.
Mm-hmm. Right, what is it they're after? Money?
No, the diamonds. I still have them.
What are they worth?
Oh, a quarter of a million.
Guilders or francs?
Oh, dollars.
Oh, dollars. Did they ask for anything else?
Nothing. Santé.
It's early in the morning, but I suppose we need it. Right, these diamonds, where are they?
In the bank.
And the instructions?
We are to pick them up at 12.
We?
Oh, yes. And we are to use your car. They insist on that.
And when we've picked them up, what then?
They said there would be further instructions. They also said that Nico's death and Harm's death were not accidental.
Mm-hmm. Pour encourager les autres. Well, what are you doing? It's only 10 to 10.
Oh, I'm phoning the bank to tell them to have the stuff ready. You will go with me, won't you?
I don't think I have any choice.
He's looking out now. He's worried.
He's troubled.
You have the answer. It's in your hand.
You know what? I'm the last one who should say this to you, but your only chance...
My last chance is to do as they say.
Your only chance is to ring Schiphol and reserve a flight to anywhere in the world that takes off around 1 o'clock.
Even if I got away with it, I'd never be able to move without looking over my shoulder. No. I give them what they want. It's the only way.
You know, don't you, Diane? Finally, they're after you.
That's a chance I have to take.
And you know best. By the way, does Philippe have a younger brother?
No. Why do you ask?
Because yesterday I was followed by a young man who looks remarkably like him.
We'll have to leave in 10 minutes if we're to make the bank by 12.
Well, what about the instructions? Did they say they'd phone again?
They said nothing.
Look, they must phone again for the instructions. They're going to make us sweat it out to the last minute, aren't they?
It's 12:30.
We can't wait any longer.
Let's go.
I should let you take a chance on Schiphol.
No, it's better this way.
No, I don't think so. Now, look, when we get there, you go into the bank alone. They didn't insist we both go in the bank, right? I'll wait in the car. That'll split their concentration, and then I may be able to spot one of them.
Of course, we don't know how many there will be.
Right, we don't. I've only seen one son, but it could be a whole family.
Pete?
Yeah?
If you're contemplating anything, don't. I know these people. Let's do it exactly their way. I don't want you to get killed. Especially on my account.
Thank you.
2 minutes to.
Shall I go in?
Give it a minute. Okay, now. And don't hurry. Take your time. Peter 2 to HQ.
HQ, Peter 2.
Patch me through to Effett, quick as you can, please.
Effett?
Effett? I'm parked outside the Van Lanschot Bank in the Polish Potterstraat. Get here as fast as you can, will you? Tail us wherever we go. If we have to split up, follow her. Out. You got the stuff?
Yes. I also got this. The teller said a man left it only 5 minutes ago.
So that's why we didn't get another phone call, eh? Well, we're on the road now. No turning back. Come on, Effett. Where are you? Don't keep turning around.
Sorry.
Let's see if we can get someone out into the open. Here, look. Now, there's a lovely grey handbag, right?
Yes. Yes, it's beautiful.
Uh-huh. Would suit you, I think.
Can you see anyone?
No, not yet. Of course, it wouldn't match your black patent leather shoes, would it?
I'm so frightened.
All right, let's go. Don't stare at the door. Making me nervous.
How long?
Can't tell. They are obviously worrying about whether anyone's covering us. They might not show up at all, but I doubt that.
Santé.
Hals und Arm und Bein brüchen.
What does that mean?
That's the German for good luck. Actually, it means break your arms and break your neck.
What's bad luck?
Yeah.
Stop staring at the door. You're making me nervous.
Touché.
If we go on like this, we could get drunk.
Sounds like a good idea. Why not? Now, where the hell is that with?
young.
No. I'm going alone. There is nothing more you can do.
Ça va, madame?
Peter 2 to HQ.
HQ, Peter 2.
Has Hefford called in yet?
No, sir.
Well, patch me through to his car, will you, please?
Peter 5 to Peter 2. Lost them in crowds. I doubled back and checked the boutique. In a hell of a mess, but no one there. I'm sorry.
Thanks. Now, Philippe Baptiste is out. His boys are onto you. They finally tracked you down. Gotta hand it to you for nerve coming to me for help.
I really had no alternative. I knew I was taking a big risk when I went to Arras. But it wasn't just for myself. It was for my son.
Yes, give me Hofkommissar Samson, will you?
Van der Valk.